blocking my mom's exit, my grandfather had to step over them to get my mom and carry her out of the house, to get her to the hospital, to have the home I was born into a good family. March 10th was a good day. See, and when I got to the hospital, my mom's heart stopped. She had me and I had no heartbeat. I was blessed because God himself came down and said, boom, you're going to be born dead. Lucky for me, we had some good doctors because they were able to bring back my mom and me. It's not funny now when I say my name, Jose Joaquin, the guy from the church, Jose Rodriguez. And see, what ended up happening was I did not know that the first couple of minutes of my life was my first fight. I was born into this world fighting for my life. Finally, by the time my dad got to the hospital, I was already in a plastic bubble for the first few months of my life because I was weak. And I remember, the story goes, my mom would tell my father every single day that I was in that bubble, if you allow our son to die, I will kill you. I was born into a good family on that great day, March 10th, 1979. See, I was born into lies, hate, deceit, physical abuse, mental abuse, spiritual abuse, sexual abuse, every kind of abuse. Because see, if I'm going to do something, I'm going to do it right, I'm going to do it full out. That was my first couple of years. Now fast forward to time, I'm about 5 or 6 years old, and I remember the first fight that I had, besides me just trying to stay alive, was having to fight my father to protect my mom, because he liked to choke my mom. He liked to choke her when she didn't do things that he wanted her to do. And my sister, her and I, she was my road dog. See, we used to have to keep the facts. Now I want you to picture this, imagine. Little kid, all the way to your teens, you get to choose the weapon of choice for your guardian angel to get beat with. And you get to watch them with tears in their eyes choose the weapon of choice that they get to see you get whooped by your parents. See, now, my father was an alcoholic, and he was a workaholic. And just by the power of proximity, my mom became one too. Bless her heart. Now, the funny thing is, my story really isn't unique. Don't cry for me, Argentina. I am no different than y'all. You ain't no different than me. You may not have the same struggles that I had. I may not have the same struggles that you had. But we all one the same. See, now fast forward to a time I'm about 10 years old, and somehow my sister and I, we used to perform as our outlet to be able to escape from our reality, to become anyone we wanted to. And like I said earlier, my father, great man, he made sure that we had every possible opportunity to make something out of ourselves. So they decided to sell everything. The businesses, the family businesses, our four-story home, our living maid, and we packed everything up and we moved to the land of free, good old America. That's right. And we got here to L.A. And I walked in, looking like I did, mine's tattoos. Looking different, talking different. Didn't speak the language very well. And I would go to school and I would say my name, hey, my Joaquin Diaz wanted to take over for Rodriguez, and people would laugh. And I'd be bullied. So I got it at home, and I got it in the USA. I didn't fit in anywhere. But still, somehow we performed, and I made it through. But you know why I made it through? Because I had courage. My family taught me before I knew what was going on. I had strength. I had confidence. I was a 5-year-old grown man. By the time I was about 15, I was already in drugs. I was already robbing people, stealing cars, selling drugs. Was way past my sexual experience. Shoot, that happened when I was about 8 years old. And I knew that I had to take a risk because I saw myself and I said, there's got to be more than what I have. And so I made a decision to take ownership of my life. I didn't fit anywhere. Hell, I was even a crappy gangster. Now imagine this. You're a gangster. Beating people up, getting in the hood, telling your homies, hey yo, I can't gangbang y'all today, I gotta show you. That's funny. And I realized this wasn't me. I was in that too. I was trying to find a way to fit in. Just make stupid choices. And now fast forward even more. At 15, I made a choice. I helped my sister, my love. I ran away from home. I brought her to high school. I found my way to working a 9-to-5, believe it or not, as an accountant. A dumb little kid with no degree figured out how to lie his way through a resume. But you know what? One thing I do have is resourcefulness and a relentless attitude and a hunger to be better, to want more, to thrive. And I wasn't going to let anything stop me. And now throughout my teens, I'm living on my own, doing what I got to do, making decisions, hitting rock bottom. I became an expert at hitting rock bottom and bouncing back. And I realized that there were 3 important things that helped me get to where I am today. And that was changing my physiology and my focus and my language and my beliefs. Because come on, we all have limiting beliefs, don't we? We all have that inner critic telling us that we can't do something, that we're not good enough, that we're afraid, right? Y'all feel me? And then I realized something. That there was something more to this dress for success than these guys. It wasn't your fancy clothes, nice car. It was what you had in here. It was what you built in here. And I learned real quick the power of proximity, being around the right people, helping myself get better for myself. I was born into a good family. See, once I learned how to forgive my family and myself, you see, the thing is, they loved me the best way they knew how. They gave me everything they could. And still, choice I had to make because I decided to empower myself. Because I knew I could do anything. Anything I wanted to. And now, fast forward even more, I'm 40 years old. Looking back at that beautiful day, March 10, 1979, where I knew that I was born with the ability to fight. That courage was strength, conviction, confidence to become anything I wanted to be. Oh, it wasn't easy. It was a fight. A daily struggle, and it still is. But you know what? I stand here before all of you today, having traveled all over the world as an artist, a choreographer, a director, a dancer, an actor, a model. I've been on thousands of stages, performing in front of millions of people. In fact, I just finished 7 years performing for Cirque du Soleil and for Michael Jackson when I met him. That's no easy thing. You gotta be the best of the best to get to that level. And the best part is, I learned how to dress for success. I learned how to make my way and fight for what I wanted. Every single day is that challenge. And I learned by changing my language on how I speak to myself and how I let others speak to me. And I learned how to stand up straight. I learned how to change my physiology, my mannerisms, how to look at people with different eyes, how to have that confidence when someone is telling you that you can't do it. I said, oh yeah. Watch this. So baby, fuel my fire. I use the no's and you can't. So that I could turn around and say, yes, I can. Because like I started this today, you and I are different. We want the same. We all in the same boat. Go back. We come from different places. We all have different stories. We all have different struggles. But we do have the ability to be anything we want. And I want to leave you guys with something. And I want to give you guys tips, tools, and techniques for today, tomorrow, the next day, next week, next month, next year, for while you're here learning from these amazing speakers, a remarkable woman that has brought all of you guys together from all over the world. And I know that you guys are all humans, but now I stand here before you as Jose Joaquin Villar, the Chevy Costa Rodriguez, the one and only JJ Villar, who has been the person behind almost a decade of providing the live entertainment for Office Dynamics. So if you're taking this to learn today from my story, and thank you for allowing me to share my journey for the lovely ladies that are here from Dress for Success. I did it, baby. So if you would please indulge me as I help you with three of the things that I think are the most important on how to truly dress for success. And if you would not mind, please stand up. And we're going to start with the first and most important thing is your language. And I want to help you change your language like I did. And I want you to say loud and proud, "Bless your manners," right? I want to remember to take your right hand, put it up, nice proud. Put it on your heart. And I want you to say it loud and proud to where everybody on the strip can hear you. And I want you to say, "I am strong." Come on, I want you to hear yourself mean it. "I am strong.
I am strong.
I am powerful.
I am powerful.
I can do anything I want.
I can do anything I want.
I welcome challenges.
I welcome challenges.
I defy the odds.
I defy the odds.
I am powerful.
I am powerful.
I am confident.
I am confident.
I have confidence. I am me.
I am me."
Now give yourself a round of applause. So that's one. Your language. Your beliefs. Two, your physiology. So I want you to spread out just a little bit. Don't worry, I'm not going to have you do anything crazy. But what I am going to do is I'm going to give you a couple of exercises that when you have that limiting belief, that inner critic, that is telling you that you can't, that plateau when you hit that level of frustration, when you're back home or in your office or dealing with your boss or your employees or your kids or your spouses, take a moment for yourself and say the words that I just had you say to yourself. And it is how we're going to change your physiology. I'm going to give you a couple of exercises that are going to help you. I don't think you realign yourself, but when you sit down, you're going to feel nice and tall and erect. That's right. Because it matters how we sit, how we stand, and how we hold ourselves. So do me a favor and look at the seat right now. I want you to have your feet at a slight 45 degree angle, kind of pigeon toes, right? Shoulder width apart, kind of like a fist apart. And I want you to squeeze your buttocks. That's right. And if you don't know what the buttocks is, grab your hand and squeeze it firm. It's right behind you. And I want you to hold yourself upright. I want you to squeeze your abs. If you can't find it, pretend. Because right now, what we're going to do is we're going to work on this physiology. And I want you to take your arms and extend them out. And I want you to close your shoulder blades behind you and stand tall. And I want you to squeeze your abs. And I want you to squeeze your buttocks. And as we play this song right now for about a minute, I want you to draw circles forward. Come on. That's right. Turn it up. Because you are a maniac. That's right. This is a big part. Try to be as good as the way it's going to be. That's thank you. your fists like so. Put them on your temples. And I want you to squeeze your elbows tight. Take your elbows up the foot. And open them up. And keep them tight. Open them up. And keep them tight. Open them up. See your butt in tape. Stomach in tape. Open. Slow. Open. Slow. Open. Slow. Open. Slow. Are you ready for your power? Are you ready to take it up to the next level? You ready to take the front of the mat? All right. Right here, right leg back. And I want you to take a lunge in. One hand by your hips, one hand by your temple. And I want you to start running as fast as you can for 30 seconds. This is the greatest time you're going to go. Get through. Turn like this. Turn up everything. But now, as a 40-year-old man, I look back at my life and I wonder, Did I make it worse than what it was? Did I really live that? And even though I know my truth, and y'all know the older you get, the details get fuzzy. So we have the choice to focus and create the life that we want. So this is my gift to you on how to change your focus. I want you to turn to your buddy. One person is facing this direction, the other person is facing behind you, and you're going to put your hands on their shoulders, and you're going to give them the best massage.
Thank you.